Welcome explorers, today I am back with a brand new video in which I am going to show you the array implementation of stacks as well as queues. So this is a very trivial question which anyone from any DSA course might ask you. So if you want to answer all those questions, then you can watch my video. But before that, I want to tell with great pleasure to all of you that I have upgraded to Windows 11 finally from my Windows 10 setup. So the feel which I have got after using Windows 11 for a few days right now is quite good. I am quite satisfied with the feel and the system also works fine. So the system has become very smooth and also I was able to save much space after upgrading to Windows 11 and the apps are also working very fine and with some new features and upgrades. The Windows 11 is just apt to use, so you can always upgrade to Windows 11 and use whatever you want. Array implementation of stack. So the first code which I'm going to show you is the array implementation of stack in C. So for that I have first of all declared one structure named stack, inside which I have declared one pointer a, then one integer top, and then the other integer capacity. So as you all know that stack is a data structure in which we make use of the top, which is a pointer which tells us what is the top position of the stack, and the capacity. As you all know that array has limited amount of size, so we cannot dynamically allocate the size. Of course we can dynamically allocate the size, but first of all we'll have to take as input from the user the number of variables which we want to have in that stack. So as this is an array stack, we cannot dynamically allocate or deallocate the size of the array. Once we have finally allocated, we cannot do anything about it. So this is a structured stack. And I have basically used four functions. Push and pop is known by everyone. And in addition to that, I have used peek as well as display. So push function basically pushes the element on the top of the stack and pop deletes one element from the top. So basically the logic behind the push function is that first of all, you have to increase the value of top and then in that corresponding index, you have to input the element or the integer given by the user as input. So as you can see, this is the push function over here. And it is taking two arguments as input, the structure itself and also the value given by the user as input. So if you can see, we have one if condition as well as one else condition over here. So the if condition is basically checking for the terminal condition. So if the top value of the stack plus 1 is greater than or equal to the capacity of the stack, then we are exceeding the limit of the array stack. So because of that, we have to print the stack overflow message. And if that is not the case, then we have to simply increase the value of the top pointer and we have to input the element given by the user. And then we have to input the element given by the user in that corresponding position of that stack. And then we can print one message that is push success. And the next function is the pop function. The pop function deletes the element on the top and then decrements the top pointer. So inside this, we also have two conditions. The if condition says if the top value is equal to minus 1, that is, if the top value is underneath the zero index, then we have to print the message stack underflow. And if it is not the case, then we can print the pop value and then decrement the top pointer. So in addition to the top, so in addition to the push as well as the pop function, we are using two other functions. The two other functions are peek and display. So what the peek function does is it basically tries to peek into the top counter. So whatever value we have at the top location, it is going to print that. And again, it has two conditions. if the top value is equal to minus 1, that is, we don't have any element inside the stack, then we are going to print stack underflow. And if the case is not valid, or if the case is not what we are looking for, then we have to print the peak value, that is the value which is present at the top of the stack. And the final function is the display function. The display function actually displays all the contents of the stack in the order they are placed in the stack. So the top pointer, so that top value is going to get printed first, followed by the value underneath the top, and then the next value, and so on until the zeroth index of the stack. So now this is the main function over here. So inside the main function, first of all, I am declaring two integer variables, ch and v, and also the structure stack which I had defined in the start of the code. So after defining this three variables, we're going to take as input the capacity of the stack, or the maximum number of elements which we can have inside their stack from the user. We're going to take the input, and then we're dynamically allocating the array of that stack so that it can hold the number of elements given by the user as input. And then we are going to initialize the top of the stack as minus 1, as this is the norm over here. And after that, we are going to make a menu driven program. So as you can see here, our menu consists of 5 choices: push, pop, peak, display, and exit. So now, without any wastage of time, let me run this code so that you can understand what I'm actually trying to convey to all of you. So for that, you have to write gcc followed by the name of the file or program. Okay, so ignore the warning. And now let us compile the exe file. So enter the capacity of the stack. So for instance, I'm going to take the capacity as 6, and then let us push some values. Okay, so right over here, as you can see, we have exceeded the number of elements inside the stack, so it is giving me the message stack overflow. So now let us display the contents of the stack by using the fourth index, or the fourth option, that is display. So this is the contents of the stack. So the recent value, the most recent value which we had pushed into the stack, is 12. So it is giving me this stack. And at first, in the beginning of the stack, before we push the other elements, the first element which we pushed into the stack is 12, followed by 34, then 34, 59, 23, and finally 12. So 12 is the most recent element. So I know that many of you might be aware of the concept that stack uses the last in, first out principle, which is the last element which goes into the stack is going to get popped out first because it is on the top position of the stack. So if I want to use the peak function, then I will have to press 3. So the peak value is 12. So as I already mentioned, that the peak function basically gives the value of the element present at the top position of the stack. So in our case, it is 12 because it is present on the top. And now let us pop some elements. So the first element to get popped is 12 because it is present at the top, then followed by the next, 23, followed by next. So now let us use the display function. So we only have two elements in the stack right now. And now if I peek, then you can see that we have got 34. So as you can see, the peak value is 34 because 34 is present on the top of the stack at this moment. So we are going to get 34 over here. And now let us pop one more element and let us display the contents of the stack. So we have only one element inside the stack, which is 12. And now if I'm going to peek, then we will get 12 as the value. So if I pop once again, then the pod value is 12. And let us pop once again. So as you can see, we have got stack underflow because we don't have any element to pop from the stack. So it is giving us the message of stack underflow. And if I'm going to display the contents of the stack, then it is going to show me now the stack is empty. Okay. So this was all about the array implementation of the stack. And now let me exit the program. Now the next program which I'm going to show you is the array implementation of queue. So this is the code over here. Before executing the code, let me tell you what I have basically written inside this code. So as always, I have defined a structure named queue, inside which we have four variables. The first one is an integer pointer a. The next three variables are integers, front, rear, and capacity. So unlike stack, in queue we have two pointers. The first one is the front and the next one is the rear. And always capacity is going to store the maximum number of elements which can get stored inside this array queue. So unlike stack, queue follows the FIFO or LILO principle. FIFO stands for first in, first out. So the element which is going to get stored inside the queue first, it is going to get deleted from the queue first. And similarly, the last stored element is going to get deleted at last. After all the elements preceding it are going to get deleted. So this is the principle which queue follows. And in this queue implementation, and in this array implementation of queue also, we have four functions. The first one is enqueue, dequeue, peek, and display. So the peek and display are the common functions over here. And like push, we have enqueue, and like pop, we have dequeue. So enqueue is going to take two arguments, the structure queue itself and the integer v, or that is the value which the user is going to store inside this queue. So first of all, we are basically checking whether the value of rear plus 1 is greater than or equal to the capacity of the queue or not. So if that is the case, we are going to print the message as queue overflow. So it basically means that we are exceeding the maximum limit of the queue, and so we cannot store any element given by the user inside the queue. And inside the else condition, if that is not the case, then we are going to simply increment the rear pointer or the value of the rear, and in that particular index we are going to store the value given by the user. And one more condition inside the else condition is that if the rear value is equal to 0, then we have to make the value of front as also 0. So basically it means that the first time we are going to perform the enqueue operation, we are going to increment the value of rear. So if we do not set the value of front as 0, then we will get into trouble. Like the value of rear is 0, but the value of front is less than the value of rear. So that is an invalid case in the case of queue. And the next function is the dequeue function. It is going to take the queue as input. We're going to use the reference by value method over here. And inside it also, we have two conditions. If condition says if front is equal to minus 1, then we have to print queue underflow. That is, we cannot delete any element from the queue because the front pointer is located at the minus 1th index. So we don't have any element inside the queue. So that basically means queue underflow, or the queue is empty. And inside the else condition, we are going to print the deleted element. Inside queue, the deletion occurs from the front, and the front gradually moves to the right hand side of the queue, or it basically increases from the LHS to the RHS of the queue. So for that, we are basically deleting the first element, or the element where the front pointer is located, and then we are going to increment the value of front pointer. And inside the else condition also, we have one condition. If front is greater than rear, then the rear value is going to assume -1, followed by the front value assuming -1 also. So what does that mean? So if one element is deleted and the front value is incremented by one value, then immediately we have to check for the condition whether the front pointer has assumed a value greater than the rear pointer. So as I mentioned in the previous case, the front cannot be greater than the rear pointer. If that is the case, then we have to reset the value of rear and front to -1 so that we can achieve the initial condition over the queue. And as always, we have the peek function, which is going to display the required messages. If the front value is -1 or if the queue is empty, then we have to print queue underflow. Else we have some values inside the queue, which means we have to print that value. In the case of queue, the printed value should be the value presented by the queue at the front location. So we're going to do that only over here. And now the display function. The display function is going to print the queue from the front to the rear position. So this is the for loop printing all the elements from the front till the rear. And one other condition which we have over here is that if the front is equal to -1 followed by the rear also having the value, also having the same value -1, then that basically signifies that the queue is empty, or else we can print the entire queue in a single column, or else we can print the entire queue in a single row. So that was all from the four functions, and inside the main function we had done the same thing. So we have five options. The first one is enqueue, followed by dequeue, peek, display, as well as exit. So let me now run this code and show you how our code basically works. Okay, so after compiling the second code, we are going to execute the code. So in this case also, in the case of array implementation of queue also, we are going to take the capacity of the queue as 6, as we had taken in the previous case, in the case of array implementation of stack. So we are going to enqueue some elements. Suppose I'm going to enter some random values over here. Okay, so now let us input 50. Okay, so this is the message which we are getting, which is queue overflow. So as the maximum number of elements which we can store inside the queue is 6, and we are inserting one extra element, it is giving this message, which is queue overflow. So we cannot insert 23 into the queue because it is already full. And now let me display the queue so that you can understand. So now the queue is this one. So the first value which we inserted into the queue is 12, followed by 34, followed by 26, 67, 34, and 50. So 50 is the most recent element which got inserted into the queue. So 50 is present at the rear position of the queue, and 12 is at the front position of the queue. So now let us peek and see what is present at the front. As expected, the value present at the front is 12. Now let me dequeue, and 12 is deleted. So as I already mentioned, in a normal queue also, if you take the example of a railway ticket station, the queue is in the form of a long line in which the first person present at the position nearest to the counter is going to take his ticket first, and then he's going to leave. So here's the one who is going to get eliminated from the queue first, followed by the person present at the next position, and so on. So now if I run the dequeue function once again, so the value 34 is going to get deleted because it was present after 12. So likewise, if I run dequeue some more times and then print the content present inside the queue, then you will find that we have only two elements inside the queue. And now if I peek, then you can find that the element present at the front location is going to get printed, which is 34. Now let me dequeue two more times and then dequeue once again. So as expected, the queue is running out of elements, and so it is finding it difficult to delete further elements because the queue has already been emptied. So it is giving us the message queue underflow. So now let us peek and see what we get. So queue underflow, we don't have any elements, so there is no concept of front as well as rear. Both the front as well as the rear are resetted to the values of -1 and -1 respectively. Both of them have assumed the value of -1. And now if I display something, then it is going to show me the message, now the queue is empty. So that is the queue implementation of an array, or the array implementation of a queue. So from this video, I only intended to say that queues and stacks are two different kind of data structures. So although the data structure is the same, which is array, but we can implement them in such a manner so that we can show some different kind of operations being performed on them. So in the case of stack, for instance, it is going to study, or it is going to follow the last in first out principle, but in the case of queue, it is going to follow the first in first out principle. So although the basic data structure is the same, that is array, the derived data structure or stack and queue is going to differ in so many aspects. So that is the basic idea which I intended to show to all of you from this video. So guys, that's all from this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you enjoyed, then don't forget to like, share as well as subscribe to my channel for getting such informative content and know some basics of coding from me. I'll try to explore more of these topics in my upcoming videos. Until then, stay tuned and stay safe. Thank you. Goodbye.